Hello friends, welcome back. In this video we are going to study the another type of catalysis, that is the heterogeneous catalysis. So let's start with this. First of all, introduction. Now in earlier videos we have seen the first type of catalysis, that is the homogeneous catalysis. Homogeneous catalysis means in which the reactant and the catalyst both are in the same phase. Now here heterogeneous, hetero means different. So when the reactant and the catalyst, they are in the different phases, it is called as a heterogeneous catalysis, right? So the catalyst is generally in solid phase and the reactants are either in the gaseous or the liquid phase. That means they are in the different phases. The heterogeneous catalysts are used widely in the industry and have much greater economic impact than the homogeneous catalyst. Most of the catalysts are formed at high temperature and therefore they can tolerate wide range of operating conditions. One more reason for their wide use is that no additional steps are required to separate the product from the catalyst and hence resulting in efficient and more eco-friendly processes, right? Further, types of heterogeneous catalysis. Again, we are having the four types of heterogeneous catalysis. The first one is the metals. So metals, they act as the catalyst. For example, the catalyst based on the iron metal, they are used for the synthesis of ammonia from nitrogen and the hydrogen. So let's say the reaction, we are having the nitrogen and the hydrogen and they are converted into the ammonia. Second is the catalysis on semiconductors. The most successful application of the electronic theory of catalysis applies to the semiconductors. There are numerous examples in which the catalytic activity has been correlated with the number of free electrons or the holes of a semiconductor. For example, the decomposition of N2O on nickel oxide, that means a p-type semiconductors, it is twice moles of N2O which gives the formation of the nitrogen and the oxygen, right? So this is the semiconductor. Then the third type, solid acid catalyst. In many commercial processes, solid acid catalysts, they are used. Use of the solid acid catalyst in such processes become more economical and produce better quality products. As stronger acid, they have significantly higher catalytic activity compared to conventional acid catalyst and provide clean environment. An example of reaction catalyzed by solid acids is alkylation reaction. In this, combination of benzene and the ethylene results in the formation of the ethyl benzene. So let us see the reaction. We are having the benzene plus ethene which gives the formation of the ethyl benzene, that is the C6H5CH2CH3. Then the fourth type, the last type, supported catalyst. In this, the catalytic support is solid with high surface area. The surface area of catalyst can be increased by deposing on the surface of the solid, particularly microporous zeolites and the mesoporous materials. They have pores like structure and active sites for the internal surface. For example, in the synthesis of ammonia from nitrogen and hydrogen, in which the iron, ruthenium and the uranium, they are supported by the small amounts of alumina and the potassium salts. So the reaction N2 plus 3H2, which gives the formation of the NH3, and it is an example. The catalyst used is the supported catalyst. Then further, we are having the properties of the heterogeneous catalysis. So the catalyst must have high and stable catalytic activity. Secondly, the catalyst should not be poisoned by the presence of small quantities of certain substances. It must be operative at high temperature. It must have the ability to match the substrate orbitals. And it should be capable of forming complexes with a range of coordination numbers. So these are the properties. Then catalytic reactions. So the heterogeneous catalysis or the heterogeneous catalysts, they undergo catalytic reaction which are four in number. The first one is the oxidation reaction, the second one is the reduction reaction, third one is the cyclization reaction, and the last one, that is the fourth one, is the biodiesel synthesis. So these are the four catalytic reactions that we have to study in the homogeneous catalysis. So let's start with the first one. That is the catalytic reactions involving oxidation, in which the first reaction is the synthesis of terephthalic acid, that is the TPA, from xylene using the catalyst ZSM5. So what is this terephthalic acid? The other names of the TPA is parathalic acid, PTA, or it is also known as the benzene-1,4-dicarboxylic acid, that is a BDC. Okay, then the catalyst. Catalyst is the ZSM5. What is this ZSM5? It is abbreviation used for the zeolite socinimobile 5. Okay, it is a solid catalyst. It has long life due to less coke formation, and it is an eco-friendly catalyst as it reduces pollution. And finally, we can say that it makes the manufacture process cheaper. Then this terephthalic acid is prepared by the oxidation of paraxylene using ZSM5 as a catalyst. The single step reaction is, we are having, this is the reaction, we are having the paraxylene by using the catalyst as ZSM5, we are getting the formation of the terephthalic acid. That means these two methyl groups, they are converted into two carboxylic group by using the catalyst ZSM5. This is the first reaction of oxidation. The second reaction of oxidation, or before that, we are having the properties of the terephthalic acid. The properties of the terephthalic acid: it is white solid, poorly soluble in water and alcohol, sublime substance, causes eye and skin irritation, prolonged exposure causes urinary tract stones, damage to urinary tract, and even cancer also. Its uses in polybutylene terephthalates production as a component of metal organic framework, that is MOF, as a filler in smoke grenades. And finally, as a pioneer to polyesters, which are used in audio and video recording tapes, data storage devices, etc. Then the second reaction of oxidation, that is the synthesis of benzoic acid from toluene using the oxidizing agent potassium permanganate, KMnO4. So here we can say that the benzoic acid is synthesized commercially by oxidation of toluene by using oxygen, and the oxidizing agent is the potassium permanganate. So the reaction, the simple reaction is, we are having the toluene by using the KMnO4 catalyst, it is converted into benzoic acid. That means a single methyl group is converted into the carboxylic group. So this is the oxidation reaction of benzoic acid. The properties of benzoic acid: it is white crystalline solid, melting point is 122 degree centigrade, it is sparingly soluble in cold water, readily soluble in hot water, alcohol and ether. Uses or importance: present in certain resins like gum, benzoin, in balsam, found as a hippuric acid, benzoylglycine, in urine of horses. And then second catalytic reaction is the reduction, and its example is hydrogenation of alkene to alkane using Raney nickel catalyst. That means in this reaction, double bond is converted into a single bond. That is, the hydrogenation of a carbon-carbon double bond at the surface of catalyst results addition of hydrogen. So the net reaction, in the net reaction, we can say that we are having the ethene, and there is the addition of the two hydrogens. By using the Raney nickel, we are getting the formation of the ethane. Ethene is converted into ethane by using the catalyst Raney nickel. Now let us see this by using a short video. Now in this video, we can say that at the bottom we are having the catalyst, that is a nickel catalyst, right? And in this nickel catalyst, we are having the hydrogen atoms which are absorbed, and then we are having the ethene molecule, right? Then these hydrogens, they are one by one inserted at the two carbon atoms, right? That means this single bond, it is converted into a double bond, and then ethene molecule leaves from the surface. This is the simple mechanism for the hydrogenation of alkene using the Raney nickel, right? Further, second reaction is the synthesis of paraaminophenol from nitrobenzene using palladium catalyst. Now, paraaminophenol is obtained by catalytic hydrogenation of nitrobenzene using palladium supported metal catalyst in presence of sulfuric acid. the initial reduction of nitrobenzene to give beta-phenyl hydroxylamine as an intermediate, which then gives para-aminophenol in the presence of sulfuric acid by a rearrangement which is known as the Bamberger rearrangement. So this is the reaction in which we are having the nitrobenzene at the starting. By using the catalyst, we are getting the formation of the para-aminophenol. Then next, the third type of reaction is the catalytic reaction involving cyclization. So its example is the benzimidazole synthesis using OPD, that is orthophenylene diamine and benzaldehyde by solid acid catalyst. So benzimidazole can be synthesized by the cyclization of OPD, orthophenylene diamine and benzaldehyde in the presence of various catalysts like acidic support or clay solid support, amber list or ammonium chloride catalyst. Now, one of the method used for the synthesis of benzimidazole is, this is the reaction, we are having the OPD then benzaldehyde, and by using this amberlite IR120 we are getting the formation of the benzimidazole. And here we can say that there is a cyclization between these two nitrogens and the carbon atom. So due to which we are getting the formation of the benzimidazole, which is a cyclization reaction by using the solid acid catalyst. And the fourth one, the last one, biodiesel synthesis using the heteropolyacid catalyst. So what is biodiesel? Biodiesel is an alternative renewable fuel that is obtained, derived from the vegetable oils, animal fats, spent frying oils and the microbial oils, right? So this is the source. This fuel can be replaced petroleum based fuels and can be used in all types of currently available diesel engines without them being modified. And biodiesel is generally obtained or produced by the transesterification of the vegetable oils or the animal fats with chemical catalyst, especially in the presence of strong acidic or the basic condition. So we can say that how the biodiesel is synthesized. It requires a starting the vegetable oils or the animal fats, and by using a catalyst which is strongly acidic or the basic solution, it is converted into the biodiesel. So heteropolyacid HPA is often used as a reusable acid catalyst in the chemical reactions. And due to the unique physiological properties of these heteropolyacids, they are profitably used in the homogeneous, biphasic and heterogeneous systems. And therefore, we can say that they are excellent, environmentally benign, means eco-friendly acid catalyst for the production of the biodiesel. So let us see a cycle of the biodiesel synthesis. Here we can say that from the photosynthesis of the plants, we are extracting the vegetable oils. And after refining these vegetable oils, we are getting the biodiesel. The byproduct is a glycerol, and then this biodiesel, it is used in the vehicles. Okay, this is a cycle of the biodiesel synthesis. Okay, thank you. So here we are completed with the heterogeneous catalysis. Thank you.